Okay, ma il DF posto del sì
Okay, let's continue today also on the simple panini, not very detailed, easy panini, but remember all these chemical structures, the mineral that the enzymes name there and then what becomes what. Okay? So today's easy part there is the blood clotting mechanism, guys. Blood clotting mechanism, get this lah. You will never see blood if there is no rupturing of the blood vessel. So when the blood vessel, katakanlah this one is the blood vessel, okay guys? Blood vessel ruptures. What will go first? So this is a blood vessel. When the blood vessel ruptures there, what goes first? What type of cell goes there first? Will be the platelets. The platelets will stick together, platelets will stick together, platelets will stick together, platelets will stick together. As the platelets stick together here, they will call, is the as if the platelets are like asking for help, for help from the body there. So platelets will cause a release of this enzyme called thrombokinase enzyme there. So this thrombokinase enzyme's job is to convert prothrombin become thrombin. Thrombin's job pula is to convert fibrinogen become fibrin. Let's go one more round, let's take one shot. Yeah, a few more rounds to solve, let's make sure you're clear. Thrombokinase is caused, the platelets clumping together, coming together there, releases chemicals of clotting factors which will cause production of this enzyme called thrombokinase. Thrombokinase with two things here, vitamin K and calcium ions cause the change of prothrombin to become thrombin. That means what is the job of the thrombokinase enzyme? Converts prothrombin become thrombin. What is prothrombin? Prothrombin is an inactive plasma protein. Rendah aja plasma protein, you must know, is produced by the liver. So this will be the means in your body right now, there is prothrombin. Metaphorically is sleepy. But when got enzyme thrombokinase, the prothrombin will be woken up, then become thrombin. Now becomes active plasma protein. When becomes active plasma protein here, this fella will go and convert fibrinogen become fibrin. What is fibrinogen? Fibrinogen is an inactive plasma protein also. So, yang ni pun sekarang ni, you have it now also in your body, but it's inactive, it's sleeping, it's resting there. But when your thrombin will convert the fibrinogen become fibrin. Fibrin now will become active plasma protein. Now focus on this guys, how does this fibrin work? Fibrin, so again, so this is the blood vessel. Blood vessel is ruptured. What will happen is this fibrin fibers, is this fiber, this neck that forms over the blood vessel. So what happens here is all the red blood cell cannot go out, white blood cell here cannot go out, all get trapped here. So when they get trapped here, they cannot move anywhere. Why? Because of the fibrin. Bila fibrin ni kering kan, it's already dry, that is known as the scab. Okay, can I guess clear this up? So what we call a scab there is actually the fibrin. Fibrin, the wet form, when it's dry, it's called a scab. Okay, so this is how the whole process, yeah? Platelets clump together, release these clotting factors, chemicals here, which will cause production of enzyme. This is an enzyme. Enzyme is thrombokinase, must have vitamin K and calcium ions. What is the function of the calcium ions? Enzyme punya coenzyme. The helper for enzyme thrombokinase will be calcium ions with the presence of vitamin K. What is the job of vitamin K? Is to produce this. Like, that means kalau you kekurangan vitamin K, means you cannot produce prothrombin. Then prothrombin will be converted become thrombin. Thrombin will convert fibrinogen become fibrin. This is blood clotting mechanism. So you must know. Don't think of these two as two different things. This one is the glamour name when it's sleeping, inactive. This is the glamour name when it becomes active. Inactive, active. So benda sama. These two benda sama. When you write essay ke structure questions, you must be very careful. I don't go and say thrombin becomes fibrinogen. No, thrombin converts fibrinogen to fibrin. Okay, thrombokinase converts prothrombin to thrombin. Okay, then related to this, related to this chapter here, got two parts, got two diseases that we must cover, two conditions, two diseases that we must cover. So the scab is what, guys? The scab is the outer. That's why when you got a cut, the cut is not even, it's uneven. Why is it uneven? Because that's the scab, right? That is the fibrin. Okay, so it covers the wound, make sure the blood does not come on that. Now, other than the time we have diseases related to this, diseases related to this, simple one. The one we call hemophilia. What is hemophilia? Inability to clot. Why? Just now, you guys, I was telling you here, got platelets. Platelets wake up, clump together, release chemicals here. These chemicals are known as the clotting factors. So, if you got no clotting factors, you do not have these chemicals, clotting factors, it means your body cannot produce thrombogenesis, this whole process will not occur. That's hemophilia. So, hemophilia means, it means your blood cannot clot. Hemophilia got different ranges of hemophilia. Some can be very severe where the person can actually die from simple cuts. Katakan knee there got cut ke apa, can bleed and die from that cut. So it can be even that severe or got some mild form of hemophilia as well. Alright, then one more thing is thrombosis. What is thrombosis? What is thrombosis that? Is when the blood gets clot inside. Contohnya kalau saya ingin tahu guys, this is the blood vessel means the clot must occur over the wound. Over the wound. So fibrin, this would be the fibrin. But now what happens is the fibrin forms inside the blood vessel. So when it happens inside the blood vessel, blood cannot move. When blood cannot move, this thing here is called the process is called thrombosis, but this is called the thrombus. So what's the thrombus? The clot that happens inside the blood. Okay, so this one quite simple. Why I'm giving you a simple worksheet this time? Because the previous part there, we got a few things like the blood vessels. I want you to finish up. Do all this. That means you got 3, worksheet number 12, worksheet number 13, this worksheet number 14. Finish up all the latte. And the chapter, they shortly, you don't have to plan part. Some parts are already no longer there. So quite a straightforward part. Make sure you clear on all the parts. And settle the parts. I'll probably do the latte that is given. Latte very simple this time, guys. I'll take you about 1 hour, you can settle everything from here. Okay? So just stay consistent, make sure you know your work there. Remember, your syllabus for bio is really tough. Tough in the sense that there's a lot of parts to cover them. Still got another 4 heavy chapters to go. Okay? So guys, take care, have a good week.